All right, I'm very happy to be here, guys. So me and my dad, we went to Whataburger, and there was this guy. He was a big, tall guy, white guy, and he had quarters in his ears. And I thought, okay, it's kind of weird lifestyle, but I thought, okay, it's cool. So I'm not gonna, you know, be normal and ask him, what do you got those in your ears? I'm just gonna stare at him for like maybe 5 minutes. And my dad too, he was there like, you know, his change was 20 cents, so he got two dimes to put them in his ears. You know, he's like walking around, you know, and the dude started looking at my dad like, oh my God, like, what is it? And I'm like, oh my God. First off, he's gay. So I'm like, oh, I'm freaking out, you know, and he's looking at my dad. I don't know how I'm supposed to respond. I'm looking at my dad. And he's there, and like, he goes to his friend, and he's like, hey, look at that guy over there. Look at him over there. Look at this. All I can think is, okay, maybe he thinks like we're a family. Like, okay, my grandma has pennies. My uncle over there, he's got the guy with the quarters. So just the tree, the family penny, the family change. Right? And so we keep going, and my dad, instead of like leaving, you know, because it's kind of embarrassing to get and you know, he goes up to the register. I'm gonna get a milkshake. I'm gonna get a vanilla milkshake. He says, I don't want that one, okay? He goes up to the register, and the big white guy, who can I take your order, seriously? Yeah, milkshake. I was like, oh, okay. So you ever see a vanilla swirl? I was like, no, where's that? Yeah, we never went back. Anyway, so I can understand it's kind of like weird to be a cashier. Like, I'm a cashier, and I don't get normal people in my store. Like, I wish I got normal people. Like, this audience is amazing. Thank you guys so much. But here's the thing, I don't even know who this dude walked in, he had the overbite, the haunch. He didn't make it obvious that he was pretty obvious of what he was gonna get. He didn't go like get hot Cheetos, Takis, the Clorox, a tarp, knife, rope, okay, and then he leaves in a white van. This is not the white van your grandma drives in. Okay, this is a white van that makes people disappear. So I was freaking out. And the next day goes by, and this dude showed up, and I thought, okay, I thought nothing of it, all right, he's just walking in. But instead of, like, he was on the phone, okay, he was around his phone, and he was his hand, but like, he just walked in and said, like, hey, yo, man, what's going on? Yeah, I got you some water. No, oh, you want this? Okay, I'll get it right now. I was like, you sure you don't want to, like, just, like, you know, hot Cheetos, Takis, and then that stuff? You don't want to just, like, no, oh, stop yelling at me? And then he left. I thought, okay, maybe he lost connection, you know. But then he comes back and he had a real phone. He's like, hey, Rebecca, how's it going? Yeah, I just talked to him. Yeah, he's doing okay. I mean, you want to talk to him? I keep it in. I told him, get Takis and then this tarp and the rope and the, you know, and the Clorox. And yes, I'm talking to Rebecca. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Okay, I'll see you guys later. All right, that was my time, guys. Thank you so much.